on your mark, ready, set, let's go. Dance floor pro, I know, you know, I go psycho when my new joint hit. Just can't sit, gotta get jiggy with it. That's it, now honey, honey, come ride. DKNY, all up in my eye. You got a Prada bag with a lot of stuff in it. Give it to your friend, let's spin. Everybody looking at me, glancing a kid. Wishing they was dancing a jig here with this handsome kid. Take a cigar right from Cuba Cuba. I just bite it, just for the look, I don't light it. They'll wait to hand, they on the hand, stay off play. Give it up, jiggy, make it feel like foreplay. Yo, my cardio is infinite. Ha ha, Big Willie style's all in it. Getting jiggy with it. Getting jiggy with it. Getting jiggy with it. Getting jiggy with it. What? You on the ball with the kid? Watch your step, you might fall trying to do what I did. Mama, I'ma come close side in the middle of the club with the rubber dub. No love for the haters mad cause I got floor seats at the Lakers. See me on the 50-yard line with the Raiders. Met Ali, he told me I'm the greatest. I got the fever for the flavor of a crowd pleaser. DJ play another from the prince of this, your highness. Only bad chicks riding my whip. South to the west, to the east, to the north. Bump my hips and watch them go off, but go off. But yes, yes, y'all, and you don't stop. In the winter order, summertime. I mix it high, getting jiggy with them. Getting jiggy with it. Getting jiggy with it. Getting jiggy with it. 850 IS, if you need a lift. Who's the kid in the drop? Who else will slip? Living that life, some consider a myth. Rock from South Street to 125th. Women used to tease me, give it to me now, nice and easy. Since I moved up like Georgia Wheezy. Cream to the maximum, I'll be asking them. Would you like to bounce with the brother that's platinum? Never see Will attacking them. Rather play ball with Shaq and them. Flatten them, like getting. Thought I took a spell, but I didn't. Trust the lady of my life, she hitting. Hit her with a drop top, with the ribbon. For my mom on the outskirts of Philly. You trying to flex on me? Don't be silly. Getting jiggy with it. Getting jiggy with it. Getting jiggy with it. Getting jiggy with it.
The world, and as you took your attitude, brace yourself, cause grace is big. You're so unbelievable. You're so unbelievable. You're unbelievable. Unbelievable.
Oh. Friday night when I come out in that field, I just remember all the things I've done over summer to prepare for this and everything, and all 4 years of hard work and everything I've done. You really feel it when you come out there, you know, you feel all the pressure and you see all the people out there watching you, and you know, and you're real happy and you're excited and everything. You know, I feel great when I go out there.
Well, the first Friday I was going out there, I mean, we're getting ready for the game in the locker room. I was just getting excited and everything. I was a little nervous, you know. I had butterflies in my stomach. It was like that before every game. Until that first play, right after that first play, I was ready to go for the rest of the game.
The thing that was going in my mind the first Friday night was to put all the practice that we did into action. You know, going out there, killing the other team, as you say, or whatever. Just making the big play.
When I walk on the field, it's the best feeling ever. I mean, even my sophomore year was the biggest thrill, and ever since then, even up to my senior year, and 2 days being so hectic and having such a young team, and then going out there and coming together, even though we were such a young team, you know, it made, you know, made me realize that even though we are young, we can get the job done and do what we have to do.
When I walk out on the field on Friday night, it's just a feeling you can't explain, you know? It's just like something you gotta be there. And the crowd's just going crazy and just your blood's flowing and everything you work for, it's at night, so just lay it all on the line for your team and everybody.
Well, on Friday night, when I walk out on the field, I got so much adrenaline pumping through me, I just can't stand it. I just want to get out there. Before, I'm real nervous. But as soon as I get on the field, just cracking heads, all I like.
The single most important thing I've learned from Coach Cherry is probably discipline. Discipline and, I guess teamwork, I would also say, is I learned from him. You know, he's a great coach, along with all the other coaches we had. You know, I'm not going to just single out Coach Cherry, but Coach Rabb, Coach Hamlet, you know, and Coach Benedict, they're all great coaches. And I think they all taught us a very, very valuable thing, and that's, you know, discipline, how to be a team, family.
The most important thing I learned is just discipline. Respecting the coaches, respecting your teammates, and always respect your like an opponent. Don't think you're gonna win like just because you're playing a little team. You gotta play like they're just as good as you. Like you're gonna be a tough game with them.
The single most thing I learned from Coach Cherry was to try to give it all you got. Always play hard. Put your heart into it, because without your heart, there's nothing.
Well, the most important thing I learned from Coach Cherry is probably discipline. Just being in practice on time, getting the job done, working on the off season, just coming together as a team and not goofing around at practice, doing what we have to do to be champions again.
The most important thing I think I learned from Coach Cherry was teamwork and discipline, to work together as one and accomplish a goal.
The single most important thing I learned from Coach Cherry would have to be his one and only statement, mind over matter, where mind controls your whole body and it just keeps you going.
My fondest memory is being with my teammates in the locker room, having a great time before the game and after the game. You know, it's not just the game, you know, it's the memories that you have when you're with your, you know, practices is great. You know, I love the practices. You know, it might be hard, it'd be sweating and dying out there, but you know, it's a great thing, you know, and just being with all your friends and just living life, you know, it's just great. I loved it.
Well, my greatest memory, looking back on my years, is probably, I don't know, just all the people I played with, all the new friends and people I've met while playing football.
My single greatest memory is playing football, being able to come back, because I was off for like, I only played like 2 years and I was off my junior year. But coming back to play again was the best feeling I ever had.
Greatest memory. I'd say just probably my sophomore year, whenever Coach Rabb, during our blue and white game, he pulled me to the side and said, ask me my name, said Chris Sumner. He said, yeah, I'd like to move you up. I mean, that was like the biggest thrill that ever, and I never had a chance to thank him, so I'd like to thank Coach Rabb right now for, you know, giving me the chance to play my sophomore year, which was the biggest thrill ever. And playing with a lot of great people like Nettles and Lynch and all them, and Lacatus and everybody else I played with this year, my senior year. I mean, it's a lot of memories to cherish, and I'm gonna tell my grandkids and they're gonna tell their grandkids and it's gonna go on and on.
My greatest memory about winning from high school is not winning or, you know, titles or anything. It was just the whole experience of practices and weightlifting with my teammates and the discipline I learned and just everything. It's a lot bigger than just winning and losing.
My best memories about Wellington High School football would have to be playing with all my friends and just going out there and having the most fun I ever had in my whole life.
Another turning point, a fork stuck in the road. Time grabs you by the wrist, directs you where to go. So make the best of this test and don't ask why. It's not a question but a lesson learned in time. It's something unpredictable, but in the end is right. I hope you had the time of your life. take the photographs and still frames in your mind. Hanging on a shelf in good health and good time. Tattoos and memories and dead skin on trial. For what it's worth, it was worth all the while. It's something unpredictable, but in the end it's right. I hope you had the time of your life. Something unpredictable, but in the end it's right. I hope you had the time of your life. It's something unpredictable, but in the end it's right. I hope you had the time of your life.